Hello students, this is Professor Taramati Nakod from Government First Grade College, Kunkur. Welcome back to Principles of Foreign Exchange class. It is a part 5. Today we are going to discuss the financial derivatives. So in earlier class we have discussed about the options. In today's class we are going to discuss about futures. These are the financial derivatives. First, futures. Future or a currency future are another method of hedging or minimizing the risk that may be due to fluctuations in exchange rate. The features of a future market are as follows. First, it is traded through a clearing house. A clearing house functions like a stock exchange or a currency exchange market that provide facility for buying and selling in foreign currency. First, it is done through clearing house. Second one. Currencies are traded in a standard size. Example, at Chicago International Money Market, currencies are traded in following size: Australian dollar 1 lakh, Canadian dollar in 1 lakh, pound sterling 62,500, etc. In exchange of American dollar in India, BSE, NSE, MCX offer future trading in dollar, pound, yen and euro. The standard size is 100 of those foreign currencies. Then, delivery date are also standard, like March, June, September, December, means quarterly they are issued. Okay, popular currencies like dollar, pound, euro, yen, etc. traded. Okay, next, international money market. Chicago is the first and the most popular clearing house. Apart from this market, have developed in London, Paris, Tokyo, New York, Singapore, Sydney. A currency future is defined as a standard agreement with an organized exchange to buy or sell some currency at a fixed price at a certain date in future. Okay, here also there is an agreement to buy or sell the currency at a predetermined rate on the specific date. Okay, next, future contracts are entered through clearing house. It is not directly done by two parties. It is done through clearing house. Then, authorized members have access to clearing house. So, trading, that is buying and selling in foreign currencies, only by the members. So, as we are doing it in clearing houses, it should be done with the help of their members. Customers and the brokers who want to enter in a future contract have to enter a deal through authorized member of clearing house. Just like your share market, you are doing through brokers. In the same way, you can do it here also. Now let us understand how the clearing house is there. So when I say if two people want to buy and sell foreign currency, they are not doing it directly, they are doing it through broker. A has a broker, B has a broker, and these brokers are the member of clearing house. So the contract is done with the clearing house through the broker between A and B. Okay, it is very easy to understand with the help of this. Then a deal is in standard size and the duration for 3 months. A deal may be entered for 1 lakh at rupees 60 per dollar to be delivered by 31st March and entered on 1st January. Members, that is Mr. X and a Y, have to keep a margin balance on behalf of their client. Okay, so margin percentage is determined by a stock exchange. It may be up to 10% depending on the status of the member. As per the deal, X has agreed to buy a dollar at a rupees 60. So X is a buyer, he is agreeing to buy it at rupees 60, and Y is a seller and he agrees to sell it at rupees 60. Every day quotations are announced by the market. In India it is by RBI. The deal price is compared with the daily quotations and the difference is adjusted to the margin or a deposit balance. So here the deal between these two people are settled every day. Now take example, if market price moves to rupees 62, since Mr. Y has promised to sell it at rupees 60, he has to sell at rupees 60 only. That means in market it is, he can sell it at 62, but according to his promise he has to sell it at 60. So when you compare the agreement rate with the market rate, the Y has to sell it at 2 rupees loss. So here this 2 rupees loss is debited to his account and credited to X's account, because instead of getting 62 from the market, he is getting it at 60 rupees from Mr. Y. So X has a profit, it is to be credited to him. Y has a loss of rupees 2, it is to be debited to his account. Then the next day, if a market price dropped rupees 58, a difference of rupees 4. Now see, here the agreement rate in the first deal it was 60, but the next day it is automatically set at a market price of the previous day. So market price of a previous day was 62, so it becomes an agreement rate. So here 62 is an agreement rate between them. Then he is a buyer, X is a buyer, Y is a seller. So he will buy it at rupees 62, means he is buying it at more than the market price. In market it is 58, but according to his agreement he has to buy it for 62 rupees. So he will incur a loss of rupees 4. Okay, and this will benefit the Y. So X account debited with rupees 4 and Y account is credited with rupees 4. So in this way, every day the accounts of the buyer and seller are debited and credited on the basis of their benefits and losses. Every day price is marked to the market price. Market is a price which is compared to the market price, and a difference is adjusted in margin deposit. It may continue until the settlement day, or it may be closed before that for the prevailing market price on that day. So as we have said, it is for 3 months. You can continue for 3 months, or if you don't want to continue till 3 months, in between if you want to drop, it can be dropped or it can be closed on the market rate prevailing on that date. The deposit balance in the account is taken by the member after the settlement, that their profit or loss. So every day there is a settlement. So once the settlement is done on that day, the account holder may get, if he has a profit he will get it, if it is a loss he has to pay it. Okay, then if a margin balance is reduced below a particular level, a clearing house may insist on making additional deposit balance. The purpose of insisting on deposit is to ensure performance of their promise by the respective members. Members will receive such amount for their respective clients. The said margin amount is always maintained in bank account notified by clearing house. The clearing house has absolute control over such funds. Normally, there is no physical delivery or an exchange of a currency. It is closed to receiving or paying the difference amount. Normally, the deal are closed before maturity date by entering into a reverse future deal. Buyer of a future deal may negotiate a deal for the sale of the same through the broker and sell the vice versa. So, as we said, there is no physical delivery, and only the difference amount is paid and accounts are closed. Next, the main purpose of a future deal is not physical delivery of agreed currency, but only to cover risk due to price fluctuation. They actually don't want a foreign currency, but they want to cover the risk of loss by purchasing the future deal. Clearing house is a financial institution that guarantees performance of contract between both the buyer and the seller of a future deal, because they are insisting on the broker to maintain the minimum balance of their customer so that the clearance can be done very easily between them. Buyer and a seller have an obligation to a clearing house to perform their part of promise as agreed in the contract. The deal between two parties is cleared each day by debiting or crediting their respective account based on prevailing market rate on that date. Okay, then what are the benefits? First, benefit of future market market is a future market deal has following benefits. It is less costly as compared to your forward market, the commission, etc. The amount of premium what you are here paying is less than the other type of hedging. Less risky because the clearing house acts as an intermediary and they are going to ensure the settlement on the date of the final maturity. Next, standard size. So they are traded in a standard size and a fixed currencies. You cannot change the value of a currency and the foreign currencies. As it is offered by the clearing house, you have to take it as it is. Freedom to liquidate contract before maturity. If you don't want to continue till the closer, you can close it in between. Guarantee. So here future deal is monitored in clearing house. So there is a certainty and a guarantee of completing the contract. The deal will be enforced through clearing house, that is recognized body. Okay. What are the demerits of a future deal? A future deal has following limitations. Limited market. So it cannot be offered by everyone. So if you want to go for the deal, you have to go for BSE, NSE or MCX for getting futures. Limited currencies. So you cannot get it for all currencies. You can get it for dollar, Australian dollar, euro dollar, etc. Yen and pound. In India, you can get dollar, euro, yen and pound. Only member can deal. Okay, you cannot directly deal it. It can be done through the members. They are offered in the standard size. If they say thousands, that means you have to fight in terms of thousands only. Neither less than that. It cannot be bought in fractions, right? Next, now let us understand the difference between forward and the future contract. So forward contract is a contract between two parties where one person agrees to pay or to deliver the foreign exchange at a specific rate. Okay, so here both the parties are abide by their contract to exercise it, right? Now let us see what is the difference between forward and the future contract. So the format of forward contract is customized. It is decided by the parties. Futures, they are decided by the clearing house. So they are in standard format. Then place. So it is over the counter exchange. Then it is through some exchanges, clearing houses they are doing to deal it, like stock exchanges. People. Here anyone can enter into a forward contract, but here only members of the exchange can enter into future contract. Maturity, so it is determined by the parties whether it is for 1 month, 2 month, 15 days, etc. But in futures, the maturity, it is standard, that is quarterly. Size determined by the parties. So the size is also determined by the futures, that is clearing houses for futures. Price is determined between the parties, but here it is market determined price. On the date of the settlement, what is the rate? That date, that rate is taken for the settlement. Every day the market price is taken for the settlement. Guarantee. So here there is no guarantee, there is only two parties, but here guarantee by the exchange. Then cash flow. Here it is done after the maturity, but here the cash flow is done every day, daily settlement of profit or loss to each of the party. Currency, so it can be done for any currency, but it is offered in some limited currencies. Parties, here they are the dealer, here the members of clearing house. Students, today we have discussed about the futures and the difference between futures and forwards. We will take up some more financial derivatives in the next class. Till then, take care. Thank you.